Hello everybody. Oh my gosh, it feels like forever since I have made a YouTube video. Thank you so much for bearing with me. I have been really busy with my work, my modeling, and also just had some family stuff to deal with, so it has been a bit hectic, but thank you for hanging on and waiting for me. I so appreciate it. I love having you guys as a part of my little fam on YouTube, and if you're not part of the fam already, please do subscribe and click that bell notification so you don't miss another video. They come out every Tuesday and Friday. Sorry, I took off a couple weeks recently, but now they'll be every Tuesday and Friday again. So make sure to look out for my videos and subscribe so you don't miss any. In today's video, I'm gonna be answering your questions that you guys left for me on my Instagram, all about America's Next Top Model, and we are gonna get juicy, guys. This is gonna be a good one. So make sure you watch all the way through to the end. I am shouting your guys' usernames out and talking about as many of your questions as I possibly can. So before we get into the video, I just wanted to briefly talk about this lovely gallery wall behind me. You guys have probably seen it in a lot of my videos because I've had it for like 3 years. It has followed me from apartment to apartment to apartment. I love it, and it is from Desenio, and they're actually today's video sponsor. So basically, Desenio has a lot of different options for galleries. So they really help make the design process so easy, whether you're designing a college dorm room, an apartment, a home, they have an arrangement that is perfect for your style and the size of the wall that you're putting it on. So it made it super easy for me to design something that looks like luxurious, even though I have zero design experience. And I'm gonna tell you guys about my prints. So this is my lovely lady. I just love the female form, so that's why I got that one. I think it's really gorgeous. And then I have this quote that says, "You don't always need a plan. Sometimes you just need to breathe, trust, let go, and see what happens." I have these lips because fashion, and a giraffe because they're my favorite animal. I have the world because I love to travel, and I have this smile sign. It's always a good reminder to smile. So those are the prints that I have. I chose them in all black and white so it would kind of look like cohesive and go with the rest of my little apartment. But they have colored prints, and they have such gorgeous prints to choose from, as well as, like I said, these galleries. So if you are interested in trying Desenio and kind of upping your design in your home or apartment or whatever, make sure to check them out. There's a link in my description, and you can get 30% off. So click that link and enjoy. With that said, let's get right into the video. Here we go. Whoopsh. All right, so I have my cell phone here, and I'm just gonna be going straight from Instagram. I screenshotted some of your questions, and I'm going to just rapid fire and get through as many as possible. So this is gonna be a jam-packed video with a lot of great responses to your great questions. So let's get right into it. America's Next Top Model actually bring you as many opportunities as you thought? Like, did it really make you America's Next Top Model? And I actually have a whole video on this, so I'm not gonna go too far into it. I'll link it up here. But basically, America's Next Top Model helped me a lot in like the social media, socialite department, and it didn't help me as much in the modeling world. Like, nobody really cares in the modeling industry if you won a TV show. They just care if you're the right look for their brand and if your modeling capabilities are like up to par. All right, next question is from ZS Juke. And they say, would you do the spider photo shoot? Yes, I totally would. Do you guys remember that episode on cycle like 17, I think it was? Maybe I'm wrong, correct me in the comments, but they had a tarantula crawling on their face. And I would totally do that. Of course, I'm not like a spider enthusiast. I would prefer always not to touch a spider, but that would turn out to be such a cool shot, so I would do it for the shot. In modeling, a lot of times you have to just suck up your nerves or your biggest fears and just do things for the shot. Okay, next question is from ShackAttack502. And he says, when you go to a casting, are you known as the girl from America's Next Top Model? Does that help with castings or put more pressure on things? So, no. Nobody really knows me as America's Next Top Model when I go into castings. Usually the places I get noticed are like malls or maybe, you know, bars, whatever, restaurants, things like that. People will say hi. Or sometimes at castings, the other models will know me from the show. But as far as like clients caring about America's Next Top Model, They really don't. And that's why it's pretty much just as good for your career to have been on the show as it is to win. It doesn't make a huge difference in the actual modeling world. Of course, it makes a huge difference in the social media, socialite world, like I mentioned before. But no clients care. Usually no clients even know that I was on the show. Sometimes if there's like a natural moment to bring it up, then I will, because it's at least something to help me stand out. But they're usually not like starstruck and, oh my gosh, I have to book you right away. I don't know, I hope that answers your question. And as far as pressure, it doesn't add any extra pressure. I feel like I move pretty well in the camera and I've been modeling for 9 years, so it just comes natural, and America's Next Top Model definitely doesn't add any extra pressure. The next question is from Steph Eloise, and she says, did you like having Rita as head judge, host, or would you have preferred Tyra? Did you know that Tyra wouldn't be the judge before you started the competition? So no, I didn't know that Tyra was not gonna be the host. Like, no idea. I just remember being so confused when the judges were arriving. They arrived via helicopter. I think they showed that in the first episode. And I just remember seeing them walk out of the helicopter and I was like, who are they? Who is that? Rita was first out and I was like, is that Gigi Hadid? Is that Candace Swanepoel? Because she had her blonde hair and high heels on, and I didn't know who Rita was at the time. Now I know her, obviously. She's like a freaking megastar and killing it, but I had no idea who Rita was, and so I was just kind of like, who's that? But as the show went on and I got closer to her and everything, you know, happened how it did, I am so happy that I had Rita as the host. I love her. I think, obviously, who knows if I would have won if anybody else was the host. I loved having her. I think she did a great job despite what some of the things in the media says. I think she was so poised, and she was only like 25 when she was hosting, which is a year older than me. Hosting America's Next Top Model, like, good for her. Some of the girls on the show were even significantly older than her. So I think she did a great job. I loved having her. Tyra would have been cool because it's like, you know, obviously legendary to have her as the host, but Rita was perfect and I'm so grateful that everything happened the way it did. All right, Rachel Kidwell. I would just like to say thank you to this gal because she is so active on my Instagram and I think on my YouTube as well. So I always like to give a little shout out to people who are so active like that. So thank you for being such an active part of my community, and just know that I notice, I see you, and I'm so grateful. All right, so she says, were you ever edited in a way you didn't like? How did you handle it? So no, like, I wasn't really edited in a negative way at all, but I will say that sometimes they took my responses to a certain situation and took that reaction and put it in response to a different situation. For example, like, if something happened on this Tuesday and I said, oh my gosh, that was so crazy, they would pull that and like put it as a reaction to something that happened on Thursday. So luckily it was never in a negative way. Like, it still made sense and it was still what my reaction would have been. But imagine, like, for some of the other girls who said, she is such a, or, you know, said something really bad about, let's say, Courtney, but then they put it in reaction to, let's say, Marissa. Like, what the frick? They're basically being shown on TV calling somebody a bad word that they didn't mean to. So anyways, by the way, neither of those names matter. They just were the first ones that popped into my head. But yes, some of the girls got majorly screwed with the editing, I feel like. Although everything that was said actually was said. Nobody was forced to say anything. So I think because I was just well behaved and always kind of pleasant and in a good mood for the most part, they couldn't really screw me with the editing. So no, I wasn't edited in a bad way. All right, B Nipples? I don't know how that username is pronounced, but anyways, if you weren't a model, what would your backup career be? So this has changed a lot. Like, I have studied, not studied in school, but just like done my own research and learned a lot about copywriting and social media management. So I feel like that would be a really natural career to go into. I've already worked in both of those career paths, so I feel like I'll probably end up there. But recently I have just felt like I have this calling to be on camera and like be an on-camera personality. And I also think that it's more about like being myself. So whether that's, you know, hosting a TV show or interviewing people on the red carpet or having this YouTube channel, I feel like I thrive showing myself, my actual personality. So I don't necessarily want to go into the acting world. I did just get signed with my commercial agency, so hopefully you'll see me in some commercials coming up, but commercial acting isn't really acting. It's like basically modeling with words. So anyways, I don't really know where I'm going to go, but there are a lot of options, and like I said, I just feel like I have this calling to be on camera, so I think I would have to go into some path having to do with that. All right, next question is from Selma Selimovic, and she says, by the way, I'm not opening each profile and seeing what like their pronouns are or anything, so if I say she or he or they and it's not the appropriate one, I'm sorry, and I'm not trying to be incorrect or inconsiderate. I'm just trying to get through the questions as quickly as possible, and I'm just going off of the username. I should probably just say they for all of them because I'm unsure, but just know that if I make a mistake, it's not intentional, and please don't take offense to it. What would you do different if you had a new chance? What is your, oh, it's like a three-part question. I'll just do the first one. What would you do different if you had a new chance? And my answer would be absolutely nothing. I know that is cheesy, but I think if I changed one thing along my path during the show, that it wouldn't have turned out the way it did. I probably wouldn't have won if I frickin' had chicken instead of fish, or I don't know, like, I don't know, those are just stupid examples, but I feel like everything happened exactly how it should, and it obviously turned out perfectly. So no, I wouldn't have done anything different on the show. The only thing I would have done differently is after the show, I would have taken a lot more advantage of the social media exposure and just like brand exposure I got. I didn't know how to handle that, and I think I had a lot of missed opportunities because I was just simply oblivious to that whole industry. So that's the only thing I would change. Next question is from Hope Sander, and they say, were there any scary medical moments for you or any of the girls? So I don't know if you guys remember this, but Justine fainted in the comeback dance challenge, and I think that was the only time that the ambulance ever had to be called, but it was just so hot and we were dancing in this big dance studio, I don't know, but it was like New York summer, 100 plus degrees, and Justine fainted because honestly, we weren't getting enough food and water, and someone was gonna faint because of how we were being treated. And of course, immediately after that happened, she was taken in an ambulance, and then the producers are like handing out waters and, do you need to sit down and do you wanna take a break? And I'm like, oh my gosh, we should have been doing this before the fainting, but whatever. But that's it. Other than that, no, there weren't any medical issues, thank the Lord. Oh, Courtney did fall and had to wrap her elbow, but no, not really any other medical issues, nothing serious. All right, Charlotte loves pizza, love your handle. She says, how do they know what clothes or shoe size they need for the shoots, or do they just have random ones and hope they fit? So I'm gonna talk about the general modeling world as well. So shoes are always so funny because on set, they basically always have size 9. So if you're a size 9, yay, almost all the shoes will always fit you. But if you're a size 10, you gotta squeeze. If you're a size 7, 7.5, like me, you just always will be wearing big shoes. And that's literally how it goes. I've gotten so used to walking in heels that are too big for me, or posing in heels and making them look like they fit. There's a certain way to position your foot to make heels that are too big look like they fit. So I've learned all the tricks, and I'm sure girls with bigger feet have learned all the tricks to squeezing into smaller shoes. So basically, they don't care about your shoe size. It is listed on our comp card. This is my comp card right here, and all my measurements and shoe size are listed there. So they could look at our cards and actually figure out what shoe size we are, but it doesn't make sense for the client to like buy a bunch of different sized shoes. And then as far as America's Next Top Model, I can't really remember. I don't think they cared about our sizes either. We weren't very size diverse as a cast. We didn't have any like curvy girls, so we all were pretty much the same size. Although I will share one story, a little behind the scenes moment that you guys didn't get to see, and that would be when Binta, bless her soul, was so kind to switch outfits with me, because maybe you guys remember there was this episode where there were a rack of clothes and they go, okay, you get to choose your outfit and 1, 2, 3, go. And we ran over and everyone got to pick which dress they wanted. And I obviously didn't give a crap, as I never do, so I just let everybody pick, and then I took one and I was like, okay, great. Unfortunately, I could not even get that dress to zip up, it was really bad. And I was like, okay, great. Like, I'm gonna have to wear one of my own dresses to this challenge and just be okay with it and rock that. And I just was set on that, and I was like, this is gonna be freaking embarrassing. And I was asking every girl if she could switch with me, and finally Binta is the one who did switch with me. But anyways, let's move on past that topic. I was just thanking Binta because she was willing to give me her outfit when mine didn't fit, so that was really sweet. All right, next one is from HayleyAnn86, and I'd like to thank this person too because she is always one of the first ones to comment on my YouTube, so thank you so much for being one of my subscribers and just being so loyal online. I really appreciate it. She says, what's one thing that you learned from being on America's Next Top Model? And as far as modeling, I would say pretty much nothing. Like, I'd been modeling for 5 years before the show. I already knew the drill. I knew the deal. But I would say the thing that I did learn on the show was just about that whole, like, boss business brand stuff that they were, like, jamming into our heads. And I really didn't even think that models needed to have that. I was just like, yeah. We're models, we go to a casting, we don't even have to have a personality. Here's my comp card, boom, 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 wanna hire me? And I'm learning now that it actually is a benefit to show your personality and really be yourself at castings and have that little quirk that maybe makes you stand out amongst all the other girls. And now I realize modeling can be like an empire. You can have your social media following, you can have a brand, you can have your modeling, you can have acting, and all together it makes this really like awesome cohesive brand that people are super into. So from the show, I learned that models are not just models anymore, we're way more, and I didn't even consider that before the show. Okay, the next one is from Gabre Ukulele, and they say, were the celebrities you met nice to you? Yeah, all of them were pretty cool. A lot of them I really didn't get to talk to, like French Montana, I didn't even share a word with. Amber Rose was quite cold, like just a little bit closed off. I'm sure she's really sweet. She seemed really sweet. I just didn't get to like talk to her that much one-on-one. But like the ultimate really, really nice ones, I would say, were DJ Khaled. He's exactly how you would expect, super motivating, super kind, just loving, like dad figure. And then Golden Barbie, Jasmine, she is such a sweet girl. And I've seen her like all over the place, and she always makes an effort to come say hi to me, and I just think she's so sweet. And then of course, Ellen Von Unworth, who is the photographer for the nude shoot. If you haven't heard me talk about the nude shoot behind the scenes, I'll link it here. But she is so sweet and just like an amazing woman to shoot with. Next one is from Jay Garboski, and they say, did you spill to any of your friends or family that you had won the season, or did you keep it a secret for them to find out as it aired? So if you spill that you won too early and like it gets out, they will literally fly you back and re-record the finale so that the other girl wins. Like, it is a super strict situation, but it was like impossible not to tell anyone. So hopefully I won't get in trouble now that it's aired, but I did tell my boyfriend at the time, and then maybe a couple weeks after that, I ended up telling my dad, and he was so happy, of course. And you know, I'm really close to both my parents, my mom and my dad, but my mom is a bit of a a bit of a loud mouth. Sorry if you're watching this, mom, hello. Not a loud mouth, just, we call it oversharing. She just is proud of her kids and likes to tell people. And so I was like really nervous about telling her, and I actually didn't for a while. My dad knew and my mom didn't. But I ended up telling her. She got it out of me. And luckily my boyfriend at the time and both my parents were very good at keeping the secret, but everyone else in my life, friends, other family members, did not know, including my siblings. So I have the cutest video of them watching the finale and just like freaking out when I won. That was such a cute moment to watch on camera. And yeah, so I kept a pretty good secret, you know, let it out to a couple of people, but for the most part kept it very quiet. All right, next question is from Laura A. Her, and she says, for every model that didn't make it to the next round or photo shoot, do they actually pack their bags and go home, or do they just go to the hotel and wait until the show is finished shooting? So I find this so interesting because I didn't know this before the show, but yeah, when they say you're going home, you're not actually going home, you're going to a hotel where you have to stay imprisoned until the end of the show. And luckily I didn't have to experience that, oh thank the Lord, but the other girls told me that it was just miserable and you hardly got to go outside, and they took away your whole summer basically, and they would get like the smallest number of opportunities to step outside and like take a walk or go shopping or something like that. The only time that I got to experience that hotel was when I got to stay in this lovely suite for one night after the finale. It had like 2 bedrooms, 2 kitchens, a huge living room, and I just got to stay there for like 3 hours after the finale because we had to wake up for our flight. So that's the only time I saw the hotel, thank goodness. Frick, the gardeners are getting louder outside. Bless their hearts. Thank you for doing the mowing. But anyways, we have a question from Brian Bosp SP, something like that. And he says, are you still talking to some of the other contestants? And this was one of the most commonly asked questions. I pretty much don't talk to any of the girls, but like Chris Leanne and I will engage with each other on social media. I love Talk Tiana, so you know, we'll also engage with each other on social media. And then as far as like actually seeing people in person, I pretty much only see Courtney at this point. When it was outside of COVID, I would run into the LA girls all the time, which are Chris Leanne, Corianne, Paige, Courtney. Like I would see them at events and stuff, but now there aren't events, so you have to go out of your way to hang out with somebody, and the only person I'm doing that with is Courtney. Next question is from Leah Morris, and she says, did you find the experience changed you in any positive ways other than modeling? Yes, I think something that I learned was to just kind of stand up for myself and not let people walk all over me. I learned that like it's okay to be unique. It's okay to have your boundaries. Like everything about you makes you who you are, and you just kind of have to stand up for those things. So if someone said something and it bothered you, like you can say, hey, I really didn't appreciate when you said that. Like maybe we can work this out some way. I just think it taught me a lot about communication and standing up for myself. Okay, Clarky Man says, who is your top three aside from Tatiana and Corianne? So honestly, Tatiana and Corianne would be in my top three with myself if I had to choose, but obviously he says those two are not allowed. When I first arrived, my two biggest competitions in my mind were Tosh and Corianne. When I saw them, I was like, oh my gosh, those are models. And still to this day, like if I was gonna hire two girls from the show, it would be Corianne and Tosh. They just have really model-esque looks. Their bodies are amazing. They're tall. So those were the two that I was most intimidated by in the beginning, I guess you could say. But Corianne's not allowed, so I might say like me, Tosh, and Courtney, I guess. Courtney obviously has a really cool look to her, so probably her and Tosh and me. I definitely wasn't close with Tosh on the show. We didn't have any problems, but you know, wasn't her biggest fan, but she's got the look. I think she is so gorgeous, so she's definitely in my top three if it comes to like actual modeling skill. Okay, I got so many questions about Oliver Twixt, and don't worry guys, that interview is actually happening. We're still working out the details, but don't worry, I will be doing that interview finally. You guys have been harassing me about it for a long time. Not harassing, encouraging me to do it for a long time, so that's finally happening. Don't worry, be patient, but it is coming. Mwah! Precious Era says, what happened after you were announced as the winner? Can you give us a glimpse of the scenes, because we didn't see any on TV? They announced it. I freaking cried because I felt like I had to. And then they put me into a van and I was by myself and I was just sitting there like, what just happened? I'm looking out the window like, did I really just do this? It felt like a dream. I could not believes that I just won the show that I've been watching since I was freaking 10 years old. So I was just taking it all in. So once I was in the van, it was like 3 a.m. and then they had me wait even longer in the van, like 2 hours. I didn't know why, but turns out it was to go meet Tyra. And this never aired on TV, but basically they were shooting this scene where I walked out and met Tyra and she says, congratulations, you're America's Next Top Model. We look out onto the waterfront in New York City and she's just like, the world is your oyster, and we held hands and it was so weird. But basically we shot that at 5 a.m. So I stayed up all night and we waited for her till 5 a.m. And yeah, so that was what happened. And then they drove me to that hotel that was really nice. I slept for like probably more like 2 hours and then we had to get up for the flight. So that's what happened in real life. All right, the next question is from Leke. And they say, do you think your modeling career would be as successful as it is now, full-time and pay the bills, without your America's Next Top Model experience? And yes, I do think that. I was a working model before the show, so I think I would have still continued to do that if I didn't enter the show. But America's Next Top Model kind of confirmed that yes, you can do this, you should be doing this, it's the right choice. You don't need that validation in your life, but it definitely was helpful to me. And without America's Next Top Model, I wouldn't be doing a lot of the things that are paying my bills, such as social media. I get a lot of jobs through social media, such as the ad I did today for these, for this gallery wall. So like through YouTube, through TikTok, through Instagram, none of that would have been possible without America's Next Top Model. And from there, I learned how to do social media marketing for brands and copywriting for brands. So I would say entering that show did change my whole life, and not just in the sense of modeling. Just I learned so many different ways that you can make money without a degree and without doing like a mainstream job where somebody else is your boss. Okay guys, I am so sorry. I can't believe that this is going on so long. I actually have to leave. I have to run to a photo shoot. So I still have like half the questions to go through. So I'm so sorry to do this. I hate when people do this, but it is gonna be a two-part video. So if your question didn't get answered, don't worry. I'll make a part two that I'll release on Friday. But for now, I literally have to run right now. So I have to cut the video a little bit short, but thank you for watching and tune in on Friday for part two, okay? I promise it will be out. And yeah, thank you so much for submitting all your questions. And I hope you enjoyed those juicy details. Let's talk in the comments. I can't wait to hear your thoughts, and I'll be sure to actually reply to you guys, because like I said, I've been busy, but I'll get in the comments and reply to some comments on this video. So please click like if you haven't already. It really helps boost the video. Thank you. And yeah, I'll see you on Friday for part See you on Friday for part two. Have a good week, guys. Bye.